What's up, guys? This is Xander and my dad and G and Uncle EJ.
What it do? Welcome back. What we doing right now? Relationships versus relationships, part Chris.
Hey, how you doing, man? Welcome to be back for real. No.
Hey, good thing that we got to edit this. Yeah.
Make sure you I see that shit backwards. Oh my god.
Yeah.
Make sure you like and subscribe.
Just because Xander asked. Appreciate you, brother.
Please,
yes. Be polite.
Fuck it. Restart this shit now.
Bro, you could just we could edit it or we could just redo it when we get back. Talking about these relationships. We're talking about red flags in relationships. We're talking about what a healthy relationship is, what deal breakers that we have, boundaries that we have. We're just going to get into it from our perspective. Of course, we don't know everything, but we're going to check this out real quick.
So, guys, we're back from the food and that's all.
Yeah, because you know we always eating out here.
Pockets ain't empty.
Pockets ain't empty, cuz. And we ain't hungry no more either, bruh.
Relationships versus relationships, Chris edition. And so, we really want to just start out on the overall, what makes relationships romantic and platonic? You know what I mean? Sexual versus non-sexual relationships. Successful in general. So, like, what are some of the characteristics of healthy relationships to you, bro?
Foremost, I just think keeping each other honest, bro. You feel me? I think that's a core piece along with authenticity.
Authenticity.
Yeah,
that and part. Keeping people honest. Can you flesh out a little bit what you mean by keeping people honest?
Something like, you know, making sure that we keep each other 100, you know what I mean? Keeping it, making sure that we don't fall off until, you know, something that we're not, you know what I mean? Perpetrating or, like, you know what I mean? Making sure that we stay true to each other or keeping us to a higher standard, you feel me?
That's dope. Yeah, bro, like, being able to have, like, the difficult conversations at times, too. Like, telling people what they want to hear versus telling them what they need to hear.
Honesty, specifically, authenticity.
Yeah.
Got it.
I think those are two cores right there, man.
Yeah, yeah, no, I agree with you. And I think, yeah, no, I agree with you. Yeah, integrity for me is one of the first. It's really similar to what you're talking about, is being able to, I guess that's like trust in somebody being true to their character. You know, we're talking about red flags. It's like, why are you acting different than in this situation than in the other situation? You know, like, sometimes, you know, they might be showing off or something. It's like, you know, like, well, you're acting different.
Hey, listen, you know, that's not you.
Yeah. Or is it? Ooh, you know?
That's where you come in with that that year test sometimes, or that 3 month long, figure out, you know what I mean, if it's really that.
Yeah, that's the integrity piece for me. Is like, is your character true to, like, who you say you are and what you do type shit? Like, are you appearing to have love for me? Or do you truly have love for me?
I can trust Wendy to be Wendy.
Right, Melanie then be Melanie, right.
Hey, no, Kevin Gates said it actually first. Trust people to be who they are.
Energy doesn't lie. Language is primitive. Because, see, somebody that talk good to you and trick your mind. Yep. That's why I say suspect evil of no one until see it. Once see it, forget it not. For once an enemy could never be a friend. Big Sam told me when they painted you a picture, don't let them paint you another picture. You could talk good as a bitch and trick my mind. Now I'm back believing in you again. But you already showed me that you wasn't my friend, so we reward loyalty with loyalty, and we reward disloyalty with distance. I forgive you, but I ain't about to forget and be naive. That's unintelligent.
What about you, bro? Let's see if it's the same answer, bro. It'd be interesting to see the videos if you get, because every season is different.
I mean, yeah, honesty is huge. I often question what's needed to make a relationship successful, because not all my relationships in my life are nearly the same for the same reasons. Like, I have people that lie to me all the time, but I know they're lying, so there's an honesty in that.
Keep reading on that.
Yeah, so, like, I know, like, people who tell stories. I don't know why, but I also know when they're doing it, and I know when that's, like, okay.
I think that's more of, like, a buffer type thing, bro. You know what I mean?
But they're not telling the truth to you, but it's authentic at the same time.
Because it's their character type
right.
shit.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, like, that's where I draw the line, too, right? Because this is the difference between fisherman tales and tales, you know? Like, just even if it's little.
Tall tales.
You know, like, I'm like, bro, if you're going to do that to that person or say that to that person, bro, or lie about something small like that, what are you willing to lie about type shit, bro? It's like, you're supposed to be able to have the hard conversations. You know, I don't know. I don't see very much integrity in somebody who just their character is lying. Like, I get what you're saying, bro.
Going off of that, communication is absolutely needed.
Yeah, bro. Setting them boundaries and just being vocal about it. 100, you feel me? Yeah, not 50-50.
You feel me? Yeah. I don't believe in that 50-50 down the middle. No, I need 100 you, and you need 100 of me.
Yeah, bro. Facts, man.
I just don't believe in that 50-50 down the road, because that's like a win-win situation where win-win is technically where everyone is on an equal playing field. Hmm. You know what I mean? It makes it, you don't give your best. You're settling for...
Yeah, because I was thinking more like the interdependent... Sorry to cut you off. Interdependent relationship piece, where it's like equal give, equal sacrifice. You guys are... Everybody in the relationship is putting some effort towards something, some energy towards something, or leaving something on the table, compromising possibly. But here's my next... I wanted to like shift it down the line. Real quick though.
Go ahead, bro. So my 100, right... might not be at your 100, but I still gave you my 100, though. You feel me?
Right.
My 100 might be here, and your 100 might be up here, but you feel me? You're still getting 100 out of both sides.
Yeah, because it's about expertise, right? You mean their ability or capability. It's about what their ability level is on a certain thing. Mm-hmm. Like, if I'm helping you build this deck over here, like, my 100 is going to be handing you a nail. You feel me? I'm going to be like, I had one job. Like, can I get the monkey wrench? I'm going to be like, hey, Siri, what's a monkey wrench? That's funny. You know, but yeah, no, yeah. For sure, bro. That's key, too, is recognizing.
So like, you guys understand I'm a carpenter.
To go down the line with it, bro, are the characteristics that you look for, because you said every relationship is different, of course, right? But does it differ for romantic versus platonic characteristics of a healthy relationship? Or is it the same characteristics that you like look for as like your number one? We kind of went through our number one. And
our past conversation, platonic relationships and romantic relationships differ in the... expectation, boundaries you set, where you have to set those boundaries. There's a lot more to that, but that's mainly the biggest. My expectation is different of my partner versus my friends. I have less expectation of my friends, but at the same time, sometimes they can be as genuine as me and my girl, if that makes sense.
Yeah, it do make sense.
Because, like, I don't expect people to do something for me that my girl can't do.
Right, because she can do more than anybody else can do for you. That's your life partner. Right. You know, that's your, you know, so ACDC.
Again, more. That makes a lot of sense. But I feel like I have strong platonic relationships in the same way, but I have less expectation of it, which is kind of weird.
Okay, see, I agree with you up until that point. I have high expectations for all my relationships, but then obviously with your life partner, your life romantic partner, there's a lot more closer knit decisions being made.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because you guys. Bond. Right. A tighter bond, both in action, emotion, connection, and all of that. But I still hold my bros to very high standards, too. Like,
I'm not saying they're high. I'm just saying they're less. But yeah, I feel what you're saying.
Yeah. I mean, less as in, like, give me that butt. Sorry, Xander. You know, it's okay. Like, like, that's really the only difference, in my opinion, you know, I got a deeper understanding of your thought process by you going through it, which is dope and interesting, because like we're having the same questions and prompts,
right?
But different reactions, bro, because you know you're different every day, every second, as you have different input, you know.
One thing that should be a common ground in all these shits, bro, is evolution, bro. We ain't growing together.
Yeah.
What's the freaking point?
Right.
If we ain't elevating each other, then what's the freaking point? Correct. That's, you know what I mean? It's not meant to be gained off one of each other. It's to see each other grow. Yeah.
To build.
To build. To elevate.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? If you can't help me and I can't help you, then there's no point.
So it comes back to the problem is not using people. The problem is using people for ill intent. Because we're all going to use each other as far as like we just rode in your car to go down to get some food type shit. It's like, yeah. We use the car. We're using G's phone to record the shit.
You and know? You have a car.
This is my crib. Like, and I have a car. Right? And you have an apartment, nigga. So go to your home too, then, nigga.
Right?
You feel me? But like, we all are using each other. Point is, and you gotta be able to joke with each other. You know what I'm saying? Damn, like, laugh a little bit, bruh. But, yeah, like, we all come together to leverage each other's resources, energies, which is why you have to be on that high frequency, that high energy, because you want to leave feeling better than you came when you're dealing with other conduits, other people. And that's what you should seek for. Specifically for you, though, bro. Like, when it comes to characteristics specifically of healthy relationships, romantic and platonic, bro, sexual, non-sexual, are there different traits that you see in one or the other relationship, or are there pretty much the same top expectations?
I believe I hold the same. I don't think there should be a reason for me to lower standards for any type of relationship. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I hold high expectations for all my shit, and I hold myself even to a higher expectation. Mm-hmm. Because it all starts within.
Facts. I mean?
And when you start within, you're able to lead with an example. When you give that example, then others can follow. And
yeah.
And then they'll recognize it, and, you know, real recognize real, you know what I mean? And people will appreciate that more. And that makes the next... should make the next want to give you the same. You feel me? Like, yeah, I said before, you know, my best not might be their best, and their best not might be my best, but hey, best is being given.
I do have a question with regards to that, Chris, though. If someone doesn't recognize your 100, are they able to be your partner? The only reason I ask that is because, like, you're not gonna be recognized for everything, right?
Yeah.
So,
yeah,
like, is that just a fault, or is that, like, they can't be my partner?
Over time, if it's happened like that for too long, I would say, yeah, it was not, this ain't gonna work.
If it continues to happen, but it happens less and less over time,
that's workable. It shows a development being, that's growing, you feel me? There's trust that's being growing, you feel me? That's getting figured
integrity
out.
Right. And communication.
Right. Yeah. And I also asked this because we've labeled that as a red flag, right? But are all red flags, like, it's an ultimatum? Or is it just something you're looking at for warning?
That's it. Which metaphor are we using, right? We're using red flag as in the warning sign red flag, or are we going to do the soccer analogy? Let's kick it around a little bit. Let's kick it. You feel me? Yeah.
Kick as hard as you can.
Oh, I will, baby. Baby bouncy. Baby bouncy.
Kick that little big old head of yours.
I'll be taking that out. Yeah, so yellow card would be, okay, look, that's a warning sign that's pressing my boundaries, so let me communicate. Yo, that's a boundary for me.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I feel disrespected, or I feel this kind of way. Maybe it's an opinion, whatever, but you're communicating to your significant other or your platonic partner, your homie, your bro, your sis, whatever, that, like, I'm not feeling that. A red flag is something like, you know, like, why did they get out of here. That's a good way to put it.
Get out of here.
Yeah, bro, like, just the deal breaker. Yeah. Uh-oh, get out of here. I like that.
Ghost, be gone.
Yeah, it's like, get out of here, bro.
For real, you know what I mean? So what was the question again?
Well, he was asking, like, what are we talking about? He was just helping simplify what analogy we're using as far as the yellow flag, red flag, red flag.
Just to give a baseline to our conversations, honestly. When we all say red flag, and I'm saying not just us, but like the internet.
Yeah.
What does that mean? Like, let's be specific.
Define it.
Because honestly a problem I see in a lot of videos. People are like, red flag. Oh, they chew with their mouth open. Red flag.
It's like, he's a walking red flag when he expects you to plan the first date. Or any date, right?
If her Instagram is open.
If it's open.
Oh, like public? Public.
That's a red flag.
Those who can't cook are red flags.
Here we go.
Red flag. Yes.
If you wear a backwards hat in the pool, you have loyalty tattooed on the arm, don't wear sunblock, love Wolf of Wall Street.
When a boy puts a seatbelt on in the car, it repulses me.
Red flag that I seen a guy is having a mom, and even worse, having a sister.
What are you talking about, bro? Red flag.
That's a yellow flag, and it's a boundary for you.
That's a green flag, okay? On that level.
I mean, different strokes for different folks.
Right, exactly.
Yeah.
Different scoops for different soups.
Some things are just, you know, I think some things should just be not as over-exaggerated, you know what I mean? So dramatic about it, you know what I mean? It's so sensitive about the minute things.
Bro,
things
right.
that are serious, that need to be serious and really concerned and really be talked out about, You feel me?
Yeah.
That's a red flag thing. You know what I mean?
Like, literally over-exaggerating. Like, for real, though. Yeah. Like.
You know I mean? Bro, but, like, then I think about it, sometimes, if your girl didn't brush her teeth ever, red flag. That's petty.
Bro.
But that's a red flag.
And then the fact that you, like, it took a few days to realize it, too, it's like, nigga, damn, like. Red flag.
That's kind of like a yellowish, almost reddish flag type thing right there.
Yeah, but it's also like
self care.
And it's also like
doing self care. Then how can you care for me?
That's what I'm saying. But it also is petty, right? Like technically,
man,
it's not.
No,
like
it's not petty. That's self care, bro.
Touché.
If you don't care about to take care of yourself on the minute levels, because it's kind of minute, but it's not minute. You feel me? The reason why it's not minute because it's all about self care, bro. If you can't love yourself enough to take care of yourself and be presentable, you don't have the energy or the capacity even to give love or care for anyone else.
Real talk. Period. Red flag. Period. Red flag. Her room is dirty.
Yeah. Red flag.
Yeah. My room be dirty though. That's
So then maybe it's a yellow flag for you. I guess it's not really a red flag though. Honestly, because like what are we talking
space,
about? It's yellow.
Color space, color mind, bro.
But also, if I like the chick enough, I'd be like, need some help organizing.
Yeah.
You feel me? Or do you need a new toothbrush or something? Like,
yeah, but those things, what, that right there
what's going on?
Is reprogrammable. Let me not say trained.
So it's not red flags. So I think
you can reprogram all that type of stuff. You know what I mean? It's, how hard are you willing to work for this type of stuff? How much are you willing to go in depth with this to see if there's going to be a change? That's what I think it really boils down to, a lot of type of different things.
Okay. We in the characteristics. Went deep on this one. Are you going to like this one, Chris?
Transactionality.
Say that again.
Transactionality
of relationships. Are all relationships transactional, or can a relationship exist without contingency?
That's the wrong word. I edited this whole contingency is not the right word.
What's the right word?
Contingency is like an emergency.
So what's the word?
Without repercussion, without consequence, without...
I thought contingencies were like...
I looked it up.
It's a way to contain emergency.
Wow.
I've been using that word
ratchet
my whole life.
Yeah.
Hey, you never watched Iron Man? Batman? This is your plan.
Yeah, so I've heard it like that, but I've heard like chicks be like, so now you want to have all kind of contingencies, huh, about the shit? Like, meaning like...
Yeah. A way to secure a situation.
Oh, so I guess it's right. It's like, she's like, oh, you have escape routes, huh? Now you're putting on escape routes, bro. You're not being direct, I guess.
But is contingency still the right word? We'll
yeah, okay. Obviously, the smoke symbol with the black screen means something.
No.
Transactionality of relationships. Are they all transactional?
I think that there's a certain pedigree of that, where there is a transaction. It might not be a material thing or exchange or something, but you're always going to exchange some type of value when you're giving your time, your space, your mental capacity. You know what I mean? Because like people have a way of like draining you or taking a little bit of power out of you, or you know what I mean? When you give yourself to something, you know what I mean? It doesn't matter if it's a job, if it's your kids. You know what I mean? If it's your church life or whatever you're doing, whenever you're putting all that is being given some type of exchange.
It's the exchange of energies for sure.
Yeah, you know what I mean? It don't have to necessarily mean it's financially exchanges, you know what I mean?
Right? See, and there could be that aspect too, right? Like, there's a difference between doing business with somebody that you're in a relationship with versus going out and getting a bar tab or a restaurant tab or something like that. You know what I mean? Or making an investment with them. You know, those are all different types of the financial pieces. But I mean, like really the energy level, bro. Like you said, like, you know, you pour your cup into somebody type of thing. Or there's people that could bring your energy down. People that could bring your energy up.
Yeah.
There is going to be that transactionality of it, you know. But then there's also like people that are like, hey, you should drive tonight because I drove last week type shit. Or... let me borrow 500 because you borrowed 20 or whatever. It's like, bro, like, you're expecting me, you're expecting a favor because you did something for me, so you did that thing for me, so you could like put one in your pocket for later. Now that transactional relationship,
that's a one up relationship.
Is the
that's the part okay. I don't play. That one
yeah,
up.
One up, that's a good yeah. way to put it. Counting score. Yeah. Counting score. Yeah.
Score. I don't do that, man. Because when I give with not expectations of getting anything back. But I just learned something recently by reading this book. In order to give, you have to learn how to receive. And vice versa, to receive, you have to know how to give.
Yeah.
The amount that you give doesn't mean that you might necessarily get that amount back. Right. Mm-hmm. The same amount that you give.
Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It's really like the unintentional intentionality of giving.
Yeah.
It's generosity.
When you give with a cheerful heart and just give to bless because you're able to, right. And that's when it's actually truly giving.
Look at him trying to hang with the big dogs. Ah, yeah, my man. Man, before you fall asleep over there, man, what do you think about friendships? How have your friendships and your relationships been in your life at school? How's everything going there?
Good.
Good?
Learning math, reading, and tiny books like this size.
Oh, that's subjective.
That's pretty big book right there.
Yeah. I'm impressed with that one.
So, does your friends help you when you need help, or do you help your friends when they need help?
Both.
Yeah? That's good.
But the teacher helps us read it, too.
Yeah?
If it's hard for us.
That's what she's supposed to do, or he's supposed to do.
No,
or they're supposed to do.
My teacher.
Why are we like this?
It's the wrong way. This
boy. Yo. Hey. So, who's your best friend at school right now?
Sebastian and Marshall and Sky and.
And my whole rest of my class.
I think that's where your list ends. You get too many uhs.
Yeah, right, yeah. Exactly. If help them out a little bit.
If you can't figure out past the first then, you know, you might get the second then you're done.
Right.
You're done after that.
Why do you choose them to be your friends? How come you feel like they're good friends?
Because they can run fast like me, and they beat the other kids and...
Beat them like in what, running? We're about to get some clarification there.
That's
like, spaces
that,
there.
That is a father's like experience, because I didn't even think that, bro.
Like, hold on.
That's funny.
The life of a single father.
Right. So you guys, is this domination thing? You guys run the school, it sounds like.
Yeah.
Okay, so you know, similar interests, bro. It's crazy. Like back then, how do we qualify our best friends? You know, probably some similar stuff. Like we play basketball together.
That part, you know, what I mean? Yeah. That was a lot of my best friendships came from, bro. Growing up was playing sports, bro. And then I had some other good friends too that didn't play sports, but we matched on the intellectual level for me. Intelligence,
see, it's that frequency, bro. It's that science. It's natural within us. I feel like people just need to tap into it, bro. But the programming that's on media and stuff like that kind of brainwashes us in the way to think surface level and high emotionally instead of doing that channeling and like that connection on a higher level, a higher playing field, meaning like in the brain, like beyond this bodily thing.
Yeah,
can you connect with anyone?
Yeah, bro. All the time.
I have a hard time.
I see what you're asking.
I have a hard time connecting with certain type of people.
No. Yeah. That's a good answer, too, bro. That's even a better answer than me just about saying no. Because, like, you have a hard time because you give effort, right?
Yeah.
You give it the chance type shit. Yeah.
But, bro. I still give effort. I still give the patience and everything. And I try to adapt. But sometimes, let me split like this. You can't fix stupid.
Right. Or depressed sometimes.
Right.
That too.
Yeah.
I ran into this depressed ass dude at the gas station today. I was like, hey, how's it going? He said, hey, I'm still here. I'm on RNA.
Damn.
Yeah.
And I was like, man, I feel it.
Yeah.
Damn.
You know, I have a buddy of mine, right? And he used to always be like, man, I asked him how he's doing. He's like, I'm hanging in here, man. I'm hanging. I was like, what you mean, bro? You're hanging, bro. Are you Toby or are you Kunta?
Oh, you feel me? That's
and I was
deep.
Like, bro, it's the way you sound. I was like, bro, the words that you use, bro, are not sounding like you're blessed or you're living, bro. It's like, I'm living.
Yeah, you know what I mean? That's
like when you're hanging, bro. When you like you sound like you're on a rope hanging.
Yeah,
I'm barely hanging here, bro.
I'm suffocating here, bro. Yeah. I've said that before, bro. Because I'm trying to be more honest with, like, hey, how you doing? Instead of saying I'm doing well all the time, like I'm cool, or I'm hanging in there, or I'm cooling, man, I'm chill,
like,
whatever.
You're hanging by a thread, bro. Like
sometimes it feels like that, but I like how you're like, I'm living though. I'm here, bro. No matter how I feel, like honestly, I don't feel that good today. But bro, I'm alive, bro. I'm blessed, honestly.
Exactly. That's the difference,
shit,
right there, bro.
Yeah.
For real. Like
have
no matter how bad your situation is, there's a good thing that you can pull out of any situation.
I thought you were going to keep going. I had to get working for you, brother. We need to get you a towel, brother. You got your water over there, bro?
Hey, don't let me start preaching.
Yeah. Hey, look. Hey. Praise God. Yeah, let's get a fitty. Bro, let's switch it up a little bit, bro. Let's get into one of these videos.
Damn. I didn't use the light brights like that. I don't know. Is she black? Is she black?
On the right, that's Joy Taylor.
Oh, damn. Oh, ooh, Lord,
Taylor Rooks, too.
Are we recording?
Yeah,
oh my God, you gotta keep this shit out.
On her dating journey, okay, and she went out with a man twice. They had lovely dates, he paid for everything, wined and dined. Okay, two dates. On the third date, they spent a day together, ordered a bunch of things, had some drinks, had a good time. Really long day, so pretty significant bill. Let's call it a couple hundred dollars. Okay. He, because she had to put her card down for this particular place. So when they went to pay, he was like, oh, like, you know, your card is down. And now she didn't speak up and ended up paying for the bill. They had plans for another date. He texted her the next day and was like, hey, like, I had a great time with you, but, you know, I don't really see a long-term future with you. And so I don't really want to waste, like, either of our times. Like, I think you're great, but, you know, I don't want to, like, keep our date for next week that we had planned. Which I think is, like, very respectable. Like, most people just ghost. So she's
talking to me about it. She's
like, but he did, like, stick me with the bill.
I was like, what are you
talking about, stuck you with the bill? How did you leave paying? Like, she's like, oh, I just froze. So I was like, just text him and say, like, oh, okay, well, cool, like, thank you for saying that, whatever, like, had a great time too. It's three dates, it's not the end of the world. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
but like, here's your split for Saturday. There's no possible way you like, he thinks
why. So he pays for the two first dates. She pays for the second one, the third one. You want to split the third one. Why? Does it go like that in your head where I pay the bill, I pay the bill, I pay the bill, you split, and later on in the relationship, you pay some of the bills? Why? I grabbed the first two ones, and then if we tally up the two ones, you play the last one. Why? Why not?
This is not complicated. He got upset, did not send her the split, and in fact went and sent her the receipts for the last 2 days.
Why is she so sharp about that?
Mm-hmm. All right, pause.
What did she just say?
She said that he sent her pictures of the receipts of the last 2 dates after she had asked for the split on the third date that she had ended up paying for.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, why is your card down anyway? Like, is homegirl giving her homegirl some type of sob story or whatever the case? Is she trying to ask her friend to agree with her? Like, girl, guess what he did again type shit? Or was she actually asking for some advice? That this looked like a weird pause. you know, it's like, is she trying to get her homegirl to agree with her that he did something? Or is she actually asking for real advice type shit, right? I mean, I guess, what's your opinion on it? Because I think that, it's fine. Your card was down. Something inside of you, your script or whatever, knew it was time for you to pay.
I mean, there's reasons why your card was down. I had it happen to me 100 times over and over.
Yeah, why can't the women pay sometime?
No, like, is it simple as this? Your bank flagged your car as suspicious activity for some dumbass reason. You feel me? Even though, nigga, why a car could be down?
No, I'm not talking about why the car's down. I'm talking about she put her car down as in, like, she paid for the date.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah, and so she paid for it, but then he was like, I don't want to date anymore. I don't want to waste either one of our time. It's been 3 dates. Basically, like, I'm not feeling you like that long term or whatever. Whatever his opinion was. And so she wanted to get half of the last date after she paid for it. But it would have been cool if they kept dating. She probably would have never asked him for the half and half split.
Yeah, that was petty.
Of the bit, right.
That was real petty.
That's what it's sounding like, bro.
Yeah.
And it's like, okay, so if all is good on your side and you agree with everything, you're nice and you're cool and you're generous and whatnot. But when things don't come your way, now you're this, oh, you're playing me type shit. It's like, no, you're playing yourself. You feel me? And now you and your girls is laughing and making weird faces on new thumbnails and posts that we're going to post on Instagram now. What are we going to do with this? This is funny. But yeah, bro, what are your thoughts on this, bro? I feel like you haven't...
It's not that deep. I wouldn't have... I honestly probably wouldn't have sent her... Like, bro, if some girl after 3 dates sent me the bill for the last date, I would just not answer. I'm not going to pay. But I'm not going to send no screenshots.
You'd be that ghoster.
Yeah, exactly.
Why waste more energy?
Yeah, it's like...
That's real.
It's really not that deep, but some people feel that way. Like, you gotta get tit for tat. Like, even, I get it, that's not my style, but...
Yeah, way to bring this back down to earth. Yeah.
I don't get the tit for tat bullshit. Yeah.
No, neither do I.
Transactional.
Yeah, like, yeah. I really don't care about that, but some people do.
Red flag. Good thing they're not going on no more dates.
That is a red flag. Tit for tat is a red flag. Eye for the eye. Yo, that's fucking straight up red flag.
Makes the world blind.
Yeah.
All right, red rum.
You can't give without expecting to receive something right away. You know what I mean? Like I said earlier, you have to be able to receive, though. But, like, you don't give the expectations of having something coming back.
Real talk.
Give to bless.
Real talk.
It's called a cheerful giver.
Yeah, and God loves one.
Yeah.
Yeah, God loves everybody. But hey, here's another good point too for our fellas out here, man. Don't be taking chicks on extravagant dates and stuff, whining and dining them, telling them that you love them, just so you can get what you know I'm talking about. Because that's also wrong. You feel me? You're gonna get what you deserve, bro, in this universe. And so, when you got a gold digger or something coming at you, don't be surprised if that's how you're moving. You know? So it goes both ways, straight up.
Reap what you sow.
Right. Why? Now don't only watch the yellow and red flags that people are giving you, but watch the yellow and red flags you're giving other people.
Congratulations, you played yourself.
I feel like this is a great place to stop right here. Realationships versus relationships. The part Chris.
Two-Face G University out.
Out here.
Say bye, Xander.
Bye. Good night.